Hi, bienvenidos, welcome to my mountain. Are you ready? Well, I'm gonna try and get you ready by showing you some letters and some fun things to do here on my magical mountain. I'm Miss Marvie, and I'm so glad you came to visit again. Today, we're gonna be talking about manners. It's so important that you have good manners. I hope none of you forget your manners. And I have a lovely story that might help us remember some of the right things to say when we need to use our good manners. Today, we're going to be reading Clifford's manners. Clifford's a big red dog, and he has his good manners. Sometimes we forget our manners, but hopefully Clifford will help to remind us. It's Norman Bridwell's Clifford's Manners. Oh my goodness, there's lots of signs there. Hi, I'm Emily Elizabeth, and this is Clifford. Everyone loves Clifford because he has good manners. I taught him myself. Clifford says please when he asks for something. Say please. He says thank you when he gets something. Say thank you. And he writes a thank you note when someone gives him a present. Send thank you notes or an email would be good too. Clifford loves to go to the movies. He waits his turn in line. He doesn't push in front of others. He just stands and waits for his time to come. Wait your turn. If Clifford has a snack, he puts the empty bag into the litter basket. Clifford hates litter bugs. Don't litter. Littering means throwing your trash wherever you are. Find a trash can and put it in. Clifford says excuse me when he needs to pass in front of people, and do it quietly in the movies. Say excuse me, and he never talks during the show. Talking disturbs others. Sometimes we have to remind mommies and daddies of that too when they're at the movies. Do not talk during a show so others can enjoy it. When Clifford has to sneeze, he uses a handkerchief or tissue. It's a good thing he does, because Clifford's quite a big dog, and he can cause quite a stir. Use your handkerchief. Clifford has many friends. He shares his toys with them. Share. If you have a toy, you let someone else use it. That's sharing. Clifford puts his toys away when he is through. His friends help. They have good manners. Put your toys away. Clifford is a terrific tennis player. He obeys all the rules of the game. Follow the rules. We can't be a winner every time. Sometimes players disagree. When Clifford is angry, he does not hit. He just says what he feels. He's telling them in, and he's saying out. Talk, don't hit. Clifford is a good sport. He smiles when he loses. And he does not boast when he wins. Bragging means, I won and you didn't. That's what bragging would be like. Be a good sport. Clifford loves to go visiting. When he visits his sister in the country, he always calls ahead. But Clifford's a big dog. He doesn't have to use a phone. He just howls. Ow! That's how he calls ahead. Clifford always arrives on time. Don't be late. Knock before you walk into someone's house. He knocks on the door before he enters. Make sure they know you're coming, too. Otherwise, they'll be quite surprised if you walk in their house. He wipes his feet. Wipe your feet when you go inside the house. Clifford kisses his sister. He shakes hands with a friend. That's what you do when you meet someone. Shake hands. Clifford's sister has dinner ready. Clifford washes his hands before he eats. Wash your hands before you eat. You've got lots of germs on those hands. Clifford chews his food with his mouth closed. He never talks with his mouth full.
Don't talk with your mouth full. Nobody can understand what you're saying.
It's hard to understand people when they talk with their mouth full. So please make sure you chew first. Clifford helps with the cleanup. Help clean up. I bet you like to help Mommy with things and Daddy. Then he says thank you and goodbye to his sister and to his friend. Say goodbye and thank you. Everyone loves Clifford's manners. That's why everyone loves Clifford. Have good manners. And there you go. I have another story about a friend who doesn't have very good manners. We talked about him before. This is David. It's No David by David Shannon. Sometimes he forgets his manners. So we're going to see what he needs to remember. No David by David Shannon. David's mom always says, "No David." Some of you might hear know a lot too. No, David. Uh-oh, what could happen here? He could fall and hurt himself. He's trying to get the cookies. No, David, no. Should he be walking into the house with muddy feet? He didn't remember what Clifford told him to do by wiping his feet first. He's a mess. No, no, no. Oh, he's in the bathtub having lots of fun, but I think he's got a bit of an overflow there. Not too good. Come back here, David. Oh my goodness. He's not wearing his clothes. David, be quiet! Bang, 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 bang. I think he likes to have fun, but Mommy's not too happy about that. Is he thinking about others in the house? No, he's thinking about his fun. Don't play with your food, David. Oh my goodness. Well, look at that mess. Is he eating any of it? No. Is he showing his good table manners? I don't think so. That's enough, David! I guess he just shoved everything in his mouth all at once. And then, go to your room. Is he happy? No. Is Mommy happy? No, but maybe if David's in his room and is quiet, Mommy might be a little more happy. Settle down! Oh, he's like those monkeys on the bed. What can happen to him? He'll fall and hit his head. Oh, David, you're not going to be safe. Stop that this instant. Is it good to put your fingers up your nose?
No, that's gross. You've got lots of germs, David.
Put your toys away. My goodness, David. Somebody's gonna fall and hurt themselves. I hope it's not anybody like Mommy or Daddy, and especially not you. Not in the house, David! Where do we use a baseball and bat? Well, at the playground or in the backyard. Not in the house. Things might get broken. Uh-oh. I said no, David. Did he listen to Mommy? No. He's in timeout, sitting in the corner. Is he happy now? No, look at this tear. Well, David didn't quite listen, but... Davy, come here. Uh-oh. I think he's thinking about some things. Yes, David, I love you. Even though David did some things that weren't quite the best manners, Mommy still loves him. And I'm sure your mommy still loves you, even if she says no a lot. Well, he didn't remember a lot of the things that Clifford had said, but I have a little bit of magic because our letter is going to be for the letter M, and we're going to get my magic hat in just a second. Let's look at our letter M. This is the letter M. And we have an uppercase M, lowercase M. This is a map, Espanol, mapa. How do we make the M? Well, we always start all our letters at the top. Go down, down, up, down, lowercase M, down. Go around the hill and around the hill. So I have some words that begin with the M sound. M says M, M says M. Every letter makes a sound, and M says M. Here's the M. This M isn't as straight as this one. Be careful when you make your M. You want to try to make sure when you make your M that you have two straight lines and two diagonal lines. Boy, that's a big word. I'm going to show you. When you make your uppercase M, straight line, go back to the top, slide down, go up, and slide down. These two lines are straight, these two lines are diagonal. That's a very grown-up word, diagonal. It's just like a sliding board. Sometimes I call them my sliding board lines. Let's look at it again. That's an uppercase M. Straight line down, slide down, all the way, go up, and straight line down. Now, sometimes you might see an M made this way. Two goalposts, and the diagonals in the middle. That's okay too. Never start from the bottom and go like that for an uppercase M, because we have to start at the top. Start at the top, go down, down, diagonal, and straight line down. Lowercase M. We're going to make our line go down. Come back on the same line, make a hill. Come back on the same line, make a hill. I know some of you may want to start and do that. Well, that looks something like the lowercase m. However, I started at the bottom. Do I start any of my letters at the bottom? No, none of them at the bottom. Let's try that again. I'm going to make a straight line down. Come back on the same road. Go up, 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 make a hill. Come down, go up, 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 make a hill. But we started it at the top. I'm going to do it again. Down, make a hill for a lowercase m. We're going to take that away. This is what some people do. They go like this. This is not terrible, but it didn't go back on the same line. I just made two hills. I still have my two hills, but it's better to start from the top and go around and make your hills then. Okay, I had said, M says mm, M says mm. Every letter makes a sound, and M says mm. Let's see what some M words are, and then I'm going to show you my magic hat that's going to help us remember what Clifford was trying to tell us. Here is what I like to call my M museum. Let's look at some of the things I have on my tray. I'll hold them up so you can see them. This word begins with M. It's a monkey. Monkey. This one begins with M. It is a mouse. Say it with me. Mouse. Just say mouse and we'll make the sound. Next, I have he's a friendly monster, though. You don't have to worry. He likes to be silly, though. This is makeup. Mommy might have this. Maybe if she might let you use some of it. This one is a magnifying glass. This one is a marshmallow. This one is a muffin. And I have some books on the table, on the wall. And if you give a moose a muffin is one of my favorite stories, along with if you give a mouse a cookie. There's many of those in the series by the author, Laura Numeroff. I believe she's the author or the illustrator. I'm not sure which. Check out the book and you can see. Mommy can read it to you. Okay. I did say that magic was going to be another M word. And the magic that I have here in my hat is going to help us remember what Clifford said. And what I'm going to say for a poem, when you need to ask for something, the word is please. Some other magic words are these. Thank you. Excuse me. I'm sorry, too. Try them. They'll work like magic for you. Now let's take a look at my hat. There's nothing there. Abracadabra. Let me dig inside and see what I can find. I hope he's friendly. I hope he's friendly. Here he comes. It's a monster, and he's wearing a special thing that says, say please. When you need something, you should say please. My little magic monsters reminding you to say please. Oh my goodness. Well,
I don't know. I'm trying to see. I can't see anything. I don't know if there's anything else in here. Can you take a look at it? Do you see anything? I don't see anything else. Maybe if I dig a little more, I'll find something. Oh.
Here's another monster. It says, "Say, excuse me." Yeah, if you bump into someone, it's nice to say, "Excuse me," or "I'm sorry." And I just can't believe I don't see anything. And then I dig in there and, do you see anything? Let me try again. Maybe there's more. Somebody else in there. Oh, I see something. There's another monster. And it says, "Say thank you." So if someone gives you something, you should always say thank you. If you need to ask for something, say please. And if you bump into someone, please say excuse me. So that's my magic hat and my magic monsters. I have a little bit more that I can do for magic too. Here's my container. I have this lovely ball and I'm going to make it disappear. How am I going to do that? I don't know. Let's see what I can do. I'm going to take it out and I'm going to put it over here. See, there's nothing there. There's nothing there. And I'll put it back. And surprise! It's back! Okay, well, I have some things hidden all around me, but maybe we can look at those things next time when you come to visit me on the mountain. We'll still be talking about the letter M. You can take a look now as a sneak peek to get ready for the next time. I hope you enjoyed yourself. I love when you come to visit. So, goodbye, my friends. Adios. Until next time.